In this video, we'll show you how the ioThinx 4510's innovative one-click Auto Reconfiguration function can save you time on deployment. Configuration for general remote I/O is often very time-consuming. When changing the module order, users need to configure the modules and Modbus addresses in their SCADA again. But with the ioThinx 4510, module reconfiguration can be completed with a single click and without changing Modbus addresses, which can greatly cut down on the time needed for deployment. To show you how you can do this, we've connected the laptop to an ioThinx 4510 through Ethernet, and we've connected the lights to a DO module in the first slot. We're going to turn the light on by sending a Modbus command from the laptop, and after that, we're going to rearrange the modules to show you how easy reconfiguration can be. When logging in for the first time, the ioThinx will detect that there are modules inserted. Click the Edit button and click the Auto Match button, and the ioThinx 4510 will generate a default configuration for each module. For this tutorial, we will set the name of the first module to Light, and then we will click Save Settings, and then Save and Restart. After logging into the device again, you will see the dashboard page. Go to the Security page, then enable the Modbus TCP slave service. Now go to the Protocol Modbus page and enter Light into the filter text box. In the table, you can see that the slot for the light is R01 and the Modbus address of the DO is 1. Click Save and Restart to reboot the device and enable the Modbus service. Connect to the ioThinx 4510 through its IP and port address and set the Modbus address to 1. Read back the data and make sure that it says 0. Then you can enter 1, write it to the device, and the light will turn on. Now we've powered off the device and we're going to move the third slot module into the first slot. And power on again. Log into the device and there will be a warning that there is a mismatch in the module configuration. All we have to do is click Edit, then click the Auto Match button, and the ioThinx 4510 will automatically match its saved configurations to the correct modules. Click the Save Settings button, then Save and Restart. Now let's go back to the Protocol Modbus page and enter Light into the filter text box again. We can see that the slot for our module has been updated, but the Modbus address is the same as before. This allows us to turn on the light with the same settings and command. As you can see, there is no reconfiguration needed for unchanged modules, even if you're adding a new module or removing a module. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in our ioThinx IIoT Starter Kit, you can visit our site for more information.